It's the most faint thing ever.
Okay.
Baba Booey, Baba Booey.
Hello.
David Stearns. Penis.
That, what is it, C-SPAN shit when they did that? What if you drop a little quick? Like, what if... Never mind, I'm not here.
If I drop it a little.
Okay. Wait, can you hear... Can they hear us now? Okay.
So, wait, excuse me, can, if I press this, does that mute it?
Yes, it does.
Okay, perfect. outside shot attempts from both teams. But I think the game is truly going to be won on the boards, on the offensive boards and the defensive boards.
Awesome. And could you tell us a little bit about the season that each of these teams are having so far?
Yeah. So a bit of a rocky start for both teams. Fort has not won a game, and Bay has only won one game. So this is a must-win for both sides.
Cool. Well, looking like we're going to get started soon.
Yeah.
And I believe they are announcing the starting lineup. So here we go.
Looks like that is Anthony starting off. Second up, we got Raw Bauman. He is with the primary ball handlers on the team. Third up, we got Greg Perry, the senior. And fourth, we got Akeel. Fifth and last one, Isaac Finn.
Okay, Dylan, tell us about some of the players we should keep our eyes on today.
We should definitely keep an eye on Isaac Finn, as he's had multiple high-scoring games this year.
Sounds good.
All right, tip-off.
Tip-off is underway.
I'm excited. Are you excited?
Yeah.
This is a rivalry game.
Rivalry games are going to be a little scrappy, so...
Noah, real quick, tell us what a win would mean for each of these teams.
It would mean a lot because, you know, they don't have that. Oh, no. And guys, you need
to. All right, up core. Anthony has it. Anthony up to Ra. For three. No, rebound, four. Ford on the break.
corner shot from four.
At least he's taking them.
All right, inbounds for four. In the paint, and it's good. The first buckets of the game belong to the Trappers. All right, Raw taking it up. And it's a steal by Fort Vancouver. Fort back up the court, already have an early lead. Top of the key. Four, open three, no good. And I believe Hudson's Bay has secured the ball. Isaac has it on the post, spin move, and it's good. Nice move from Isaac. Noah, tell us a little bit about the season Isaac has been having so far.
And having a killer one. It's his final year, it's his final giving. So he's been putting up monster numbers, double doubles a lot of nights.
It's a travel.
Fort right now is running a 1-2-2, so we'll see how it goes.
Is this about the start that you would have expected, Noah?
Yeah, about. It's pretty scrappy right now.
Yeah.
But a lot of outside shots, so. But, you know, they're going to win in the paint.
Speaking of, we have Isaac back in the paint. Isaac, I believe it was a travel.
Looks like Bay's going to pass.
Fort taking up the court easily. Bay still pressing. High pressure defense.
He's going to get a 5-second call. He's going to get a 5-second call.
Right, back in the paint. Fort taking it all the way around with the layup. No good. Bay has a fast break. Anthony. Weaving. Shooting. No good. Rebound. Rebound back to Fort. That was a good effort, though. And there's another steal. There's a steal by Bay. Both teams are playing hard. You can tell they both really want it. Isaac back in the paint. And, oh. That was a tough shot by Isaac, but he put it in. All right, here comes four, back up the court. Early deficit for him. Not very high scoring, but I think we both saw that coming. And tied it up, 4-4. I gotta say, both teams look like they're playing pretty good, look like they want it.
Yeah.
Inside, and there's a foul.
Yeah, Isaac just taking it to the hole every time. Really putting his back to the basket.
All right, first free throw for Isaac. And it's good. From what I've seen, he's always been a good free throw shooter.
Yeah, definitely above average.
Knows how to keep those moves down. All right, Noah, if you're four and you're playing on the road, what would you have told your team before coming out today? How would you keep their nerves down?
I probably would have said what every coach would say, treat it like a normal game, because it is a normal game. It's against your rival, so you got to be calm and collected. You don't want to, you know, do anything that's out of the plan. So.
And it seems they've been keeping to that script so far.
Yeah, just really play within the system.
There's a bucket by Fort. Tough bucket right there on the baseline.
They're going back and forth at each other.
Yeah. 6-5, early. Still early, first quarter. Back to Isaac. He seems to be the vocal point of the offense. He spins and is fouled. Isaac getting to the line early, though. You like to see it. Aggressive, getting fouls on the other team.
He's just getting to the paint every time, and that's good basketball.
Yes, it is. Noah, if you were the refs in this game, How would you call it? Would you be loose? Would you call a lot of fouls?
It's personal, but I think when the players decide is a good way to do it. But, you know, during the last seconds of every game, every ref swallows their whistle, so we probably won't see a lot of fouls under the minute mark.
And are you expecting this to be a close game?
Yeah, I am expecting this to be a close game, but a fun game.
can't wait. Isaac misses both. Four, going back up. Seems like they had an opportunity for a three, passed it up, going baseline, and it's stolen. Isaac involved again, and Anthony has it back out. Hudson's Bay playing fast, taking the baseline. No good. Isaac back up after the rebound, and there's a travel in the paint. Seems like there were a couple missed opportunities for Isaac there, a couple missed free throws, a travel in the paint.
Yeah.
You think he'll clean it up as the game goes on?
I mean, he'll probably get more of a rhythm, but, you know, that adds up. The game's pretty close, so every little – that's 4 points right there.
Yeah.
So.
Well, we'll see how it affects. That has to be a travel.
It just looked funny.
I know.
It doesn't matter if it is or isn't. It just looked like a travel.
And if you're a ref and you see that, you're going to call a travel.
You're just going to, especially at the high school level.
Maybe,
I don't know, man. I don't even think an NBA player would get away with that.
Yeah. All right. Bay takes it back up. Out to the corner. Ra has it. Back to Jackson. And inside. In the bucket. That was good basketball from Bay right there.
The ball.
Found the open man. They retake the lead here early. Has it again. Four. Back inside. In the post. And that was going nowhere. Seems like there was a little push right there after the play. And Isaac, no call. Great pass from Anthony in there. Inside. No whistle after the block. And we have a jump ball. A little physical there. A little physical.
Yeah. Okay. Seems everyone's under control, though. So.
Well, it's early. It's early.
It is a rivalry game.
Pass it back in here after a quick break. And we have him taking up the ball again. Hudson's Bay continues to apply the pressure, particularly in the backcourt.
Yeah. I think what they're really hunting for is a 5 second foul.
Yeah, and there.
But he got a little greedy there, got a foul. Little hint. A little excited.
Is it working so far in your eyes, the press defense?
I think both teams are getting what they want out of it. Fort has a slight lead right now, but I think Bay thinks they're wearing them out. So I think both sides are happy with that.
We love to see them compete, both teams playing their best. Once again, it's a game that means a lot to them. And it's a steal by Bay. Anthony's taking it up the court on the fast break. Anthony, it appeared he was going to try to take it himself, and there was a foul call. It was a nice play, coast to coast.
Yeah. Bay's a small team, so we're really built for the transition. So we really got to take advantage when we get it.
All right, Bay's under the basket. They have an inbounds here. We're going to go back out to the three-point line. Anthony again. Anthony with the jumper. He's good from that area, though. A miss there, but I think more opportunities there, and we can see a lot of buckets.
Yeah, he's got to play within the offense. He was double-teamed there.
Oh, wow. Crazy move by four on the layup. Bay's going to have to take it. Takes it back up, and there's a bucket there.
That's just a wonderful bucket.
Wow.
Just muscling it up there.
There was a foul. There wasn't a foul. They
scored. Steal.
Oh, caught him sleeping with the steal all the way.
Blocked.
Wow, no call there again. Bay continues to apply the pressure. That was a keel on the steal there. Wow, so early fireworks, you could say.
You could say. The question is, would you say?
Well, I did. All right, I think Fort is headed to the free throw line.
100%.
Number one on Fort taking the free throw. Oh, no. No, it's an inbounds.
I think it's a free throw.
No, free throw.
The ball
faked me out when the ref was.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. First
is an A from Alan Gloves. Sorry if I butchered that shooting. This is a first one.
So,
a lot of missed free throws here. Do you think there are nerves from playing in a game of this magnitude?
So, yeah, it can only be a couple of things. One, the nerves, or they just don't practice them. So I like to think it's the nerves.
Yeah, me too. All right, Bay here. Takes it up court, drives.
Oh, I would have thought that was a foul.
Thought it was a foul. He had space. They didn't call it. And Fort's taking it back up. 6-7. 6-7 early. Fort
Game's
driving.
Anyway.
Baseline. And there was a foul called there. Maybe a whistle there for Fort on the other side. Bay didn't get a whistle back there. Your thoughts on that?
I thought there was a foul for the foul could have been called for Bay, but I mean, I guess the foul could have been called for Fort too.
And there's a timeout.
High school refs do love to call fouls.
Gotta keep the game safe.
Keep the game, yeah.
All right, Noah, what is your assessment of the game so far?
I think this is a close game. Obviously, we can tell that. Both teams are sticking to the plan for the most part. Fort's doing a lot of reacting to what Bay's doing. But really, the points are coming from the paint. So
there seems to be a decrease in three-point shooting as the game has gone on. Do you think they're realizing that that's where they're going to win
the game? I think so. I mean, what the points speak for themselves. It's hard to argue with points.
Hard to argue with points, especially when they're the name of the game. We have a score correction. It's actually 6-9, Hudson's Bay. Back at the line. We'll see if the timeout helped his nerves and gave him the ability to get down this free throw.
Not much more to say other than that, really.
Free throws, I gotta say, in my eyes, are maybe the most underrated part of the game.
Yeah.
Free points, really, are what they are.
Yeah,
and he hits both. That was big. 8-9. Doesn't appear points are going to be too easy to come by, so when you get those opportunities, you're really going to want to finish them, correct?
Right. The pace is a little slow, but I think both sides are okay with that.
Bay, back in the lane, missed. Joey here, taking it back up. Tried the hook shot, didn't work. Fort's got the ball. It seems Bay is going at a faster pace than Fort, as we have an open three here. No good. And Bay has it again.
When a team thinks they have a good offense, what they try to do is outpossess the team.
Bay for three from the corner, and it's good. 12-8. Open three from the corner. Got to convert it. He did. That's big.
It's a two-basket difference there.
12-8. Travel potentially. It's Bay's ball again. And they lead 12-8 with a minute left.
I don't know the call there. Carry?
Well, Bay's ball.
That's all that matters.
Bay, you got to be happy with this quarter so far, right?
Absolutely. I mean, you're winning.
Floater from Anthony. 14-8. I created a little separation.
Absolutely. Now it's a
6-point game.
It's a 6-point game. Yeah.
Pretty obvious foul call there, I think. Bay's not happy about it. They had a fast break. It's going to be Fort Vancouver at the line.
At the high school level, some of the best ways to get points is through the lane, because not only could you get the layup, you get the foul. And as we know, the refs do like to call the fouls.
All right, in the corner here, four, holding on to the ball, take it back out. Still beyond the three-point line for Fort. They're going to drive in here, and it's blocked. Out of bounds, going to stay with them. Was a good block there.
So Fort was running their motion there. They might, if they want to get some more points, they might want to, you know, consider running something else. Running the same thing again.
Four from the
open
corner.
Variation.
He's going to take it. There's a steal.
A foul.
Wow. Bay
absolutely had a fast break there, and so it's going to be Ford's ball.
I wonder if they'll run the same thing again. And they do. Oh, but a very
open layup
just
there.
Just dumped it there. When you run the same thing so many times and put a variation on the pass, it creates confusion.
And one for Bay. Oh, no. No, they called the offensive foul. Wow.
Oh, you were shocked by that.
I am, but maybe it's because I don't see a lot of charge calls in high school basketball.
No, that does happen, actually, because refs do love to make that charge motion.
Oh, wow.
They actually do. I know.
Well, you'd love to see somebody get on the ground for their team, and Fort has the ball because of that. Fort locked.
Oh, that's the end of the quarter.
End of the quarter. Anthony's shot. Doesn't matter. We have a pretty good game here, 14-10.
Absolutely. It's a scrappy game for sure. It's a close game.
Scrappy game. I think we've only seen 1-3, maybe 2.
And that sounds about right. In the beginning, they were really trying to go for the 3, and then we realized, you know, we got to go for the game. So it's good to see that awareness from high school players.
Yeah. No, I think both teams are doing a pretty good job. Fort's on the road and keeping the game close, so can't really complain either side. Both teams would love to get a win, obviously.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And struggling. But
it seems like both can get it.
Yeah, only one can win.
Honestly, it's just about whoever wants it.
We want to give a special shout out to the technical crew here.
Absolutely. That's a hard job. You have to be constantly paying attention.
Students from Hudson's Bay working on this broadcast, as we have Anthony, deep three, and he got it.
As we were just talking about the three.
Big shot from Anthony. You think they're going to open up the game a little bit here?
It's looking like it. Momentum's a big thing, especially in high school sports. So
Fort has a lane. We have another foul call. A lot of calls here, I got to say.
I'm telling you, high school refs love the call. They love to blow the whistle.
Is this more than you've seen in other games?
I would say for a Fort Bay game, it's about where I'd expect. The refs could also be calling a lot because they want to keep it under control here, because it is a rivalry match.
That makes sense. Fort is at the line. Here's the first free throw. Bounces and goes in.
Players will call that a shooter's roll.
You believe that?
If you're a good shooter, it is.
Well, he appears to be, so.
If you miss it, if you're a bad shooter and it goes in, that's called luck.
All right, Anthony's taking it back up the court. He's been the vocal point of the offense, I would say.
I would say Isaac's been.
Well, working in tandem.
That's true.
As we speak, Anthony to Isaac, spin move, no good. Rebound 4. Good play, though.
That was a good. I mean, anything through the post is pretty good.
Good chance there. Air ball from 3.
Very similar to the first play. Oh, behind the back.
Oh, nice move. Passing around. Ra has the ball. Takes it inside. No good. Isaac. Off the rebound.
Second chance points. Great offense.
Every point's going to matter. And that was an impressive one.
That
was
absolutely.
All right, down the lane. Fort kicks it out. Top of the key. Dribble move. Almost a travel. Kicks it out for 3. Oh, and he falls down. Bay has it in transition. Fakes the pass. Nice move there. Nice move.
Bay is just built for this transition. They're a quick and speedy team. Oh, another foul.
Greg taking advantage of the transition. Getting another big bucket for Bay.
I believe we're 1-1 right now.
21-12, Hudson's Bay.
All right, so this is where games change. The one thing you don't want to do, give the team you're beating, is free throws. That's the only way to really come back, because it stops the clock and you get free points.
Hopefully Hudson's Bay can keep that down. Here we go, 2 shots for 4.
because 3 for 3. Good free shooting is Caleb Sitsevich. Apologies, very sorry.
Caleb's doing
just
a
Caleb.
Great job.
Just
yeah.
Caleb will do. And he's 4 for 4.
All right, 14-21. It's a football game right now. Two touchdowns.
That'll quickly change.
See if it changes right here. Bay inside. Bouncing around. Got it back. Jumper. No good. Isaac getting the ball. He's blocked. Nice hustle, though. Another good piece of hustle from Bay, but it's going to be Fort's ball.
There was no points there, but that was very important. It said a lot. Both teams are just hustling it out right now. And Fort ultimately won that possession.
Bay's winning the game, however, 21-14. Oh, that's got to be a foul there. He's on the ground. Teammates come over to help him. Appears to be okay.
I don't know what kind of foul that was. That was a hard foul.
Hard foul.
But, I mean, you just got to let it go. Think about the next play.
Game kind of just started, rivalry game. Maybe some emotions. Something along those lines. All right, Fort's going to go back to the line. They've been there a lot. And have a chance to get more points. First one is good.
See, now look at that. The lead is dwindling. All because of free throws.
Well, you were right on the money. All right, second free throw. That's a good bit of free throw shooting. The whole Fort team, really.
Really good free throw performance from Fort so far.
The one area where they're winning the game right now is their ability to get to the line and knock them down.
I think more than half their points are from the free throws.
All right, Bay's got it back outside. Tossing it from the corner to the top of the key. Now they go in the paint. Isaac has it again. And Isaac scores.
And one. See, that's winning basketball. Taking it to the lane. Getting it down in the post.
And if he hits this, he has a chance to extend the lead all the way up to 9 once again. Or 8, but
yeah.
High. Big lead.
Yeah.
To steal. Fort gets it up. Fort takes a shot. It's no good. Bay's back up the court. Bay.
Oh, that was a great find by Rob.
Finds Greg
in the right place at the
right time. Oh, almost a steal. Applying pressure, and now the lead is back up to 9.
Yep.
We got 5:20 left in the second quarter. 25-16 Eagles over the Trappers.
It's a big deal to have a double-digit lead. It's in the grand scheme of things, it's not, but mentally for these players, it's a big deal to see a double-digit change.
Fort with a deep three, and he drills it. That was an impressive bit of shooting.
Must be under. There's a lot of pressure now. You're considering.
Twenty-five to 19 now.
Taking it to the lane.
All right, Fort's taking it back up. They're back out. Much of their possession is spent outside the lane. They're going to take a three here as we speak. No good.
Yeah.
Misses the open three. Bay, once again, running fast up the court.
I mean, that's the big difference is, Bay's in the lane.
Hold on. We might have a steal here. All right, fighting for the ball. Everybody's fighting for the ball. Bay's got it back.
He's going to reset it. It takes a deep three.
Whoa. Oh, not even close. But
hate to see it.
You like to see the confidence, though.
Yeah. We definitely want some tough shot makers, not takers.
Well, there's a foul there. Once again, Bay struggling a little bit with the amount of fouls that they are.
It's just poor discipline.
Giving up.
Brutal. The foul difference is double.
Wow. 10 fouls to 5.
Yep.
And we have Fort back up at the line. A familiar sight. and a familiar sight again with a swish.
Absolutely.
Great free throw shooters on that team, really.
Yeah, he's got good form. There's really not much to it. Same routine every time.
This one bounces around.
Shooters roll.
Shooters roll, right as you say.
Yeah, 6-point difference.
Fort's getting a couple bounces, I think, and
yeah.
I think when you have more shots, you're bound to get more. There's another steal by Fort.
Oh, Fort in transition.
Taking it up the court, one-on-one. Oh, wow. I'm not sure what the call is there.
I believe it's a blocking and one.
There's an and one for Fort, and just like that, the game changes.
Just like now it's a...
Could be a 3-point game if they knock these down.
Yeah,
number one is back at the line again for Fort.
We're going to try saying his name. Apologies if we butcher it. Afron Melendez.
Well, whatever his name is, he's doing a great job.
He's having a great game right now.
Hitting these free throws.
Trust him with the ball in his hands.
He makes it a one-possession game.
Trust him to make these shots. There's a lot of pressure in those shots.
24-27. 3 minutes left in the half. Couldn't ask for much more than this. A close game.
Close, close game. You know the fans on both sides are loving it.
Yeah. All right, we have Isaac in the lane again, getting a tough bucket.
Good bucket. He's just out-muscling his opponent.
And timeout. Wow, pretty good basketball here. 29-24. Fort's losing by just a little.
No, not a timeout.
Oh, no. We're going to keep on rolling. Bay back up.
Oh,
another
transition.
Steal. Almost deja vu. Miss. Wow, that was a good rebound. That was a good rebound.
He just hustled. He just out hustled.
All right, Bay has it back. Lead is down to three.
Oh, from the corner.
Oh, very close to another turnover. Bay's got to do a better job of taking care of the ball.
You need a little bit of luck to win games, and that was a little bit of luck right there.
So, do you think Bay deserves to have a bigger lead than they do? Or is it about where it should be?
I think when you account for everything, everything evens out. So, Fort got some calls they shouldn't have, and Bay's definitely got some calls they shouldn't have.
So, pretty even.
Pretty even.
Pretty
if you account for everything.
All
right. So, yeah.
3-point game. Into the corner. Steps out of bounds. That's a killer. That really could kill the momentum.
Absolutely. It's just such a tough turnover because that player's going to think about it now.
Yeah.
Get him out of rhythm. Bay's really putting the turn up the heat, really pressuring them, picking them up as soon as they cross half court. Really trying to get that 5-second call.
All right. And here's Bay. They barely avoid 5-second call. Another steal.
Good
just
idea.
Have to take better care of the ball. Can't have so many steals.
Good idea. Just poor execution.
Fort has it. Fort. Another bucket. 1-point game here.
Sometimes I say the simplest bucket is the best bucket.
If my math is correct, we were up 9 at one point. Now we're up 1.
And another turnover.
That's unbelievable.
That's a momentum changer. The momentum has shifted.
It almost seems like it's not happening on the court, but the turnovers are coming from their mentality.
Absolutely. It's just when you think you've done it 100 times and all of a sudden momentum, you start thinking about it.
All right, Fort has it. Fort could take the lead here. Offensive rebound by Fort. Little hook shot, doesn't go. Bay's going to take it all the way. Greg, oh, very close. Very close to an and one, but I think he'll take the free throws.
Absolutely. And he shot it with his left, which you just know every old head loves. Misses it.
Oh, misses the first one.
What a right.
It's the free throws. The free
it
throws
is.
Have been the difference.
Free throws win games. High school refs love to call the fouls. So free throws really win games.
Well, we got a chance to make it up. Oh.
No good.
Is there a lane violation?
I believe there's a lane violation.
Killer call.
That's just I'm telling you, it's the momentum now. And that was 1 point that makes a big difference.
You don't see that call often. Well, when it's a 1 point game.
Well, usually if it goes in, the refs don't bother to come up. So
they called it there. Well, 1 point game.
Oh, pin down screen.
Hesitated. Seems like he wanted to take the three. Didn't. We're going to reset here. In the lane. Oh, rebound bouncing around. Fort's got it. They're going to take a hook shot. It's no good. Fighting for every rebound. Both teams. And it is Hudson's Bay basketball.
Over knew it when he saw it. Didn't even try to find it.
Bay has it back.
Fort's pressing now.
Fort is pressing. They reversed roles, so to speak. Bay was pressing, now Fort's pressing. I can't believe I'm saying this, but I believe that's another turnover.
It is another turnover. I mean, I guess I should have kept track. I think we're in double digits of turnovers. You know, that starts at practice, so really all about discipline.
The score is still 29-28. 53 seconds
transition.
Left.
We're built for this. Oh, great.
Could have been a foul call there. There wasn't.
What a great coordination of the body. He contorted it so he could protect the ball and lay it in at the same time.
That is a great play.
Wow.
Fort went the other way, and they just scored, stealing momentum just like that.
Just siphoning energy.
I'll tell you what, the Fort Vancouver Trappers are refusing to go away.
No, they're in it still. Oh, deep three.
Deep three by Bay. Maybe could have gotten a better shot. Fort could hold it.
Fort right now is running a 3-2. Or, excuse me, 2-3. Wait. I don't even know. I believe it's...
Whatever they're running.
2-3.
Didn't work. They missed. All the way up. Bay, physical bucket. And that's going to be the end of the half. Well, that was a good couple seconds for Bay.
Absolutely. It was going, I mean, the lead never changed, but the momentum was always going back and forth.
I got to say, I loved watching that half. I thought both teams did a great job.
Yeah.
I would love to hear your take so far.
I think momentum is a killer thing. If you just see what happens on paper, you would have no idea the kind of momentum going on here. You can see it in the players' eyes. You can feel it in the air. Yeah, you can see it in the fans, even in the coaches. It's a killer.
So, Noah, give me somebody from that half who you were impressed with.
I was really impressed with Isaac Finn. Just head to the ground. Just constantly trying to get a bucket, just grinding it out. Just those are not easy buckets. Those take a toll over time.
It seemed that a lot of the points were coming from the paint, and he identified that early and took advantage. So I would agree, he is having a great half.
Fortunately for him, it's one of his best strengths, back to the basket. And then someone on note on Fort.
I mean, number one.
I mean, he's just rock solid.
Melendez, man.
He's just knocking down those free throws. What more could you ask?
Melendez is a senior. Isaac, also a senior.
Duke of seniors.
So I think both are battling it out. Because this is a big game for both of them. This is one of their last goes. So
yeah, this is one of the last rivalries.
Yeah, no, it has been a great half of basketball.
I mean, the outside shots are—they could be. What could you say? A little less. I mean, it seems like points from the paint are really winning the game.
I think in the next half we'll see less threes and more drives to the basket.
That's what. If I was the coach, that's why I'd tell both sides, especially if I'm Bay, because that's the real moneymaker right here. And transition. You got to put your foot on the gas.
We want to thank you guys very much for listening to us so far. We're going to be back with you in just a couple minutes. And we are back. Sorry for the delay.
Yeah, we're all ready.
Had a little trouble coming to the booth, and already Fort with the bucket.
Oh,
32.
My. 1 point game now.
32-33.
33. What?
Just having a blast doing this thing.
Okay. All right.
Anthony.
Oh, he got him with that fake. What was the call there? Travel?
All right, second half. Lot can change here. 1 point game. I really would say it's 50-50.
It's, yeah. It is 50-50. It's a one-possession game, so anything can happen. And you've seen momentum. You go from 9 points to 2 points to 0 points. So anything can happen. Oh, transition. This is what we're made for. Oh.
Just like you said, made for it.
And one. Free throws are the most essential points. Very
35-32. I think Hudson's Bay could easily be up 10 if they hit their free throws.
Absolutely. If they didn't foul Fort so often, Fort might have 15 less points, 10 less points.
You can say this happened, you can say that happened. The most important thing is that they're up by three, up by four now.
You could say that. But I wouldn't say that.
All right, Fort's taking up the ball.
Corner. Oh, wow.
Operating inside the post, just like we said they might.
And he's just getting his board over and over again until he's fouled. Very similar to Isaac.
Seems like they may have taken some notes.
Are they cheating? Are they copying us?
No, I mean, sometimes you see a player doing well on the other side and you try to adopt what they're doing.
Yeah, for sure.
A little under 7 minutes.
Yeah.
Fouls are back even, so hopefully Bay can.
Yeah, you don't want to repeat a last time.
Put those down.
Really, what's going to win this game at this point? Both teams are even. It's who wants it more and the coaches, really. Whoever has better game plan, game strategy.
Who do you got right now, Noah?
Who do I have right now?
Who do you think's going to take this game home?
I think.
As we. Oh, got a
mistake. I think Bay's got the lead and they'll hang on to it.
Bay searching to go, I believe, to 2-12 on the season. Get that.
That's the goal. Hey, a win's a win.
Get that big second win.
Yeah.
All right, 34 for four.
Just took him to the paint. But
manhandled him, but couldn't finish. Bay's got to hurry up here if they want to avoid the.
Fort has the reserves in.
Avoid the. Oh, wow, another quick play. Greg is really profiting off of the fast break.
Yeah, we're just a small team, so we really got to take advantage of the speed we got.
All right, off of the.
Running a zone defense. Running a two. Zone defense. With a wrinkle in their trap.
Do you think Fort's operating too much outside the 3-point line?
Yeah. I think they want to get their baskets. Got to come from the lane.
Bay almost gets the steal. Fort gets it back. They're going to have an open shot here. They do. Missed it.
Got to make those.
Those are big. You don't have a lot of opportunities like that.
Especially wide open.
And there's a foul.
Yeah.
38-32.
Refs love to blow that whistle.
You got to like where you are if you're Hudson's Bay.
Yeah.
I think the Trappers are very much still in it. One run.
Absolutely. If I'm Fort right now, I don't think I'm too concerned. You know, a couple more points and you start to get there, but right now you're okay. Obviously, you'd like to be winning, but all that matters is the final score.
Far from over here.
Looks like Anthony's going to bring it up.
Anthony, I think he's having a pretty good game.
Yeah, he's really
strong. Steps into a three, no good, back iron.
Oh, but we get that second
Isaac,
chance.
Another big rebound, goes up.
Third chance.
Couple missed opportunities. Here we go for three, Bay, no. Another offensive rebound has to be a
fourth
foul.
Fourth chance and foul. That's why second chance courts are so crucial.
I got to say, that was a great possession from Bay. Missed a couple shots and didn't give up.
They just didn't give up. They were scrappy till the very end.
And at the line.
But these are essential. They didn't make it, so they got to make these free throws.
Almost like they heard you.
A swish is much more than 1 point. It inspires confidence for the next one.
I believe you were right.
Thank you. Hopefully you can get this over. Oh.
Off.
One of those shots, you look at it, you think it's going in, and then it's off. But shots are like that sometimes. You just miss.
They will fall. They will fall. We have four, a little under 5 minutes left. Fort's passing it around. The lead is up to 7 for the Eagles. 39-32.
Oh, and Bay's ball now. Momentum. Momentum swinging for Bay right now. If you're Fort, this is bad news.
4 minutes left in the period. 7-point lead.
Yeah, if I'm Bay, if I'm Fort, I would start to worry.
Bay,
you
quick
can't
three,
let that happen.
Another rebound.
Great job by Bay.
Takes another one. Oh, that could have been killer, but they
third chance.
Get a rebound. Oh,
oh my.
Throws it off of him.
To be so composed, drifting out of bounds, and throw it off for crazy. The composure needed, people don't understand. That looked easy, but that was very hard.
And I got to say, I love what Hudson's Bay is doing so far.
Yep.
7-point lead.
Hudson's Bay is not going to compromise their game plan for anyone.
Oh, travel there. Close. Close, but a travel.
Yeah, turnovers are another discipline thing. You can't afford them. You can't have turnovers. That's how you lose games, especially when you're winning.
What's going to take it back up? 34 has it. Back to one. He was killing them in the first half. Oh, three. I guess that was a surprising take. Jump ball.
He's just trying to get something going, but you can't rush this sort of thing.
Jump ball. Bay's going to have possession. Possession arrow.
There's no such thing as a quick lead change in basketball. So you're just going to have to grind out these points slowly but surely.
Not a lot of fouls so far.
No, it's been pretty good. In fact,
open three. Oh,
wow.
Hits it when he has to.
Got a cap. Now it's a double-digit game.
The lead is up to 10. It's been a great quarter for Bay so far.
Wide open three. Got to capitalize, and he did. Oh, he's going to try to match.
Fort back on the attack.
Doesn't even hit the rim.
Way off. Anthony, fast break.
Transition.
All the way. Oh,
Braden.
The jumper.
Oh, please.
Catch and shoot.
Just got to his spot. He's okay. It's like he's practiced that shot.
The momentum is certainly in Hudson's Bay's favor, and we have a timeout.
That's what the timeout's really for, is to try and stop the momentum. So, I mean, probably should have called it earlier, but good timeout.
12-point lead. Seems insurmountable as we watch now, but we both know that it's not.
Anything can happen, but if you're Bay, you're sitting comfortable.
What do you think the Fort coach is telling his team?
Probably what every coach says in a different way. You know, we gotta hustle. We're better than this. We could be beating this team, but you know, like every coach says that. It's, you know, there's really nothing more to add.
You hope your guys go out and play better.
Honestly, the game plan adjustment might be you got to get quicker buckets. So that means, like, getting it to your best guy and just saying go to the hole, make something happen.
We have a lot of Bay players who are putting up pretty impressive numbers.
Yeah,
I think so
it's a pretty even game from a point standpoint, but definitely Isaac's holding the front.
Yeah.
And another. Is Fort to make a three?
I don't know, but if I were them, I would stop taking them. There's a steal. Bad pass.
Can't do that. You just can't do that.
Do you think the balanced scoring attack Hudson's Bay has so far is on purpose? like from a coaching standpoint?
I think it's more of a player thing. They all realize this guy's getting the points, so we're going to feed him the ball. It's hard to deny someone the ball when they're getting points. If you're Bay right now, I think the game plan is to just run motion. Just try to run 20 seconds off the shot clock. You got a comfortable lead. You want to take advantage of that. You're in no rush.
Under 3 minutes left in the third quarter. Bay's nursing a healthy lead. Could have been big. They missed.
Second chance.
Another rebound. No.
Third
chance.
Fighting
for the ball. Bay's going to get it back. It's Isaac in the paint, and who else?
Who else? It's simple. It's simple basketball. You get it. Give it to your big man. He goes up with it, and you get 2 points.
The senior's giving it all he has today.
Yeah.
Oh, another transition. And another bucket.
It can't be much easier than that.
Anthony's excited.
You got to be fired up after that.
All right. 16-point lead now.
Oh, another one. Fort is getting reckless. Their mind is wandering.
It is 32-48. Hudson's Bay.
What's the call here?
Giving it all they have. Fort's going to take it out of bounds.
Fort here, you gotta get quick buckets. And the three's not working, so you gotta take it to the hole. Quickest way to get buckets are free throws and threes, so if the three isn't falling, you gotta manufacture free throws.
Hopefully they attack. Looks like they're gonna stick with the three.
Stick with it.
Still not falling for them. They're gonna get it back this time, though. Kick out again.
Jump start.
Wow, that was a nice move.
That was a nice move.
Desperately needed bucket, I think, by Fort there.
Unfortunately, they still have a long ways to go for them. So, but Bay is sitting comfortably. That was just, wow.
It was too easy, wasn't it?
He's just so relaxed. It's not the game's not speeding him up.
I believe that's what they call the zone.
But yeah. You'll know he's in the zone when he starts dunking.
Have you ever been in the zone while playing? No.
I think every player has.
All right, here we go. Bay. Oh, misses
something.
The layup.
That's a. You want to take advantage of your lead. You want to slow down. You're in no rush.
Noah, when a player is in the zone, could you tell us a little bit more about what they might be experiencing as they play?
Yeah, it's not so much a physical change, but really a mental change. The game is a lot slower, and your body reacts quicker.
And you think Isaac is experiencing that?
I would say a lot of the team is. When you got momentum, you really start to feel. And of course, when you're scoring, and Isaac's probably 100% feeling it.
Bay fans are happy.
How could they not be?
Fort fans.
But
that might help.
It's a little too late. But there's still another quarter to go, and we got a little bit left in this quarter. But I'm starting to think Bay's going to go home with it.
36-50. Hudson's Bay students across the city smiling.
Yeah.
Very happy that their team is doing well.
Yeah, we could lose every other game, but as long as we beat Fort, it is worth it.
Well, we almost did, but we didn't.
Yeah.
Here we go. Corner three. Way off Joey, big rebound.
Second chance. Second chance is just killing them.
Another three.
Oh, third. Wow. You may as well just miss shots on purpose at this
point. A lot of confidence in this team. They're going to take another one.
Why not? Oh.
It's almost pickup basketball to them.
Leads inspire confidence. The confidence to take a deep three, maybe, as we've seen.
Got 22 seconds left. And, yeah, Fort's ball out of bounds.
If I'm Fort here, I'm trying to get a shot as quick as possible, a good shot as quick as possible. Like that. Missed, but a good shot and got second chance.
It was easier said than done.
Oh, but a foul.
Couldn't finish.
Can't do that. Just can't do that.
50-37. Still a long way to go. We've seen
Absolutely.
Crazier things happen.
Fort's going to have to go on a run if they want to win. And it's hard to go on a run when you're down because, you know, mentally speaking, it's hard to get into the place you need to be.
Bay's going to take it all the way. Joey, no good. But they get it off the offensive
chance
rebound.
Points. It's a kill. It's if you're going for every offensive board, you're going to get it, and that's the quarter.
52-37. Let's list some players. Anthony having a good game. Greg having a good game. Akil having a good game. Isaac having a good game. This has been great.
It's just, Bay's running great basketball. Everyone's doing great. They're running their system. They're making Fort uncomfortable on the defensive end. Everything's working. No complaints, really.
All right, Noah. You got a 15-point lead heading into the last quarter of the game. What do you do as a team to make sure that you can keep the lead?
The most important thing is to stay calm. But you got to understand the clock is your ally right now. It is an important part. So you really want to waste 20, 25 seconds. You really want to put the game to a halt, honestly. Just run motion. Just run their motion and get buckets every now and then. But hopefully, you know, the lead should be insurmountable because of the time they're wasting.
Well, we shall see. Far from over. Far from over. Shout out to the Hudson's Bay cheer team.
Yeah. They've showed up every game, even and they've given the same effort even when we're losing. So it must feel nice to win by so much.
I've always thought it was underrated. They do work hard.
They do work very hard. Some say as hard as the players.
Yeah, some do say that.
Some do say that.
Well, we're picking up. Picking up again. Fort's going to have the ball. It's going to take some hard work to get back in the game, but that's a good start.
That's a must. When you've got a three, threes are a quick way to get the lead back, so those add up. You know, three threes, and that's 9 points.
They went dry from beyond the arc last quarter.
Yep. You know, live by the three, die by the three. So right now they're dying.
They're dying, but there's a little light at the end
of
the tunnel.
Something, yeah. If they make another three, then that's some confidence. That's a confidence booster.
Fort's going to have the ball back. Down 12. Bay's playing an interesting defense. Fort misses.
Got that.
They get the board back. He's going to have to watch out. All right. Fort in the corner. They go baseline. Nice move. And he finishes. We're down to a 10-point game here.
Yeah, one more bucket, and it's no longer double digits. And that's a huge mental strain lifted.
Bay attacks quickly. No. They get it back. That's big. No.
Gotta capitalize.
Another rebound. This could be massive. Foul.
Fouls are never good.
If never, ever.
Never, ever. So it's heartbreaking if you're losing, especially, because you think you get a good defensive stop, but then next thing you know, the refs blowing the whistle and they get free throws.
All right, here we go.
Oh.
Isaac has missed some free throws today. He's had a great game, but struggled a bit from the line. Do you think there's some momentum that he has?
I think it's tough to go from, you know, very physically dominating to then relying on the touch.
I'm pretty sure he heard us and made that one.
Clearly, he corrected me.
All right, Ford's going to take it up, down 11. Certainly could come back. Playing a different style of offense.
Taking
right
it to
now.
The hole and then kicking it out. They're just running their motion right now.
They found
a foul. If they make both, it's down to a 9-point game, and I would say Fort's got the momentum then. This is we're seeing a crack right now in the momentum. Fort is very close to taking it.
I don't think it would be possible to overstate the importance of these free throws as he misses the first one.
Oh, you gotta let it go, but how can you? That's so crucial.
In his mind, the goal, get it down to 10. Let's see if he can do it. A couple subs here for Bay as they try to preserve their double-digit lead. Well, here we go. It's the last chapter of the game.
Yeah, that's a fancy way to say it for sure.
Definitely is.
It sounds so elegant. Makes it sound like we know what we're doing.
Oh, I do.
No, you do too.
Okay.
Okay. Free throws here.
Oh. That's so.
In and out.
Bay's got the momentum.
Two missed free throws, and the game changed. If he hits this. He doesn't. Oh, wow. Great offensive rebound.
Just the hustle and athleticness and the coordination to come up with it.
As you see the miss, but great hustle. Fort goes quickly. They get a bucket. They bring it back down to 11. Bay, I don't understand going quickly here, but I'm going to shut my mouth because Isaac just scored once again.
You know, it's a high-risk, high-reward situation. You know, obviously the 2 points is the reward, but on the downside, Fort gets the rebound, gets transition, and then, you know, that's
the greatest defense, more offense.
Sure.
As Fort takes the ball up, they drive.
Just beat him.
Just completely misses there.
A good pass, but he fumbled it. Fort ball.
Fort's going to take
the ball. Easy call.
5 minutes left, 13 points. Can Fort climb the mountain? Your thoughts?
They can. I don't know if they will. If they make four threes, that's 12 points, and then it's a one-point difference. But, I mean, this game has been clearly a tough ask to get one three, let alone four. So, I don't know. Four isn't inspiring a lot of confidence. Oh, steal.
Great steal. Players diving.
They want the win. They just want it. They just want it more than four.
I think Hudson's Bay, and the game is obviously far from over, but they've come out and they've, I think, proven something today. Would you agree?
Yeah, for sure. I think they've proven that they're capable of winning more than one game.
All right.
Yeah, looking for Isaac. Corner.
Gonna take a three. Dagger. Dagger.
You're calling it there. You're calling it dagger.
60-44.
Leads inspire confidence.
I mean, that was a beautiful shot.
That was, you know, if you're down, you're not taking that shot. If you're down by, what is it?
16.
16 now, you're not taking that shot. It's a bad. But, hey, if you're up, why not?
Oh, man. Breaking the action. Bay's up 60-44. At what point do you bring in the subs?
When you hit the three-minute threshold and it's clear the game's over.
We'll see if that comes true. Fort's got the ball. Opportunity to score more. All right, top of the key. Backing him down. I like the effort there. Obviously a miss, but do you think they should have been doing more of that throughout the game?
Yeah, but they got to make that.
Oh, hard fall, no call.
It seems obvious, but you just got to flat out make your shots.
Tough bucket for Fort there. And we have a break in the action.
What's the hold up? Oh, the ref getting, or ref and coach having to talk a little bit. Oh, injury.
We saw the hard fall there.
I think it's probably a cramp. Hopefully nothing too serious, but he was able to walk up, so. Yeah, that was Ra who walked off.
He was crucial to the game so far.
He was, but is he needed? Still, the game is getting out of hand.
Let's find out.
Yes.
60-46.
If I was four, I would be pressing right now. So I don't know what the game plan is there.
Bay is going to take the ball up. 4 minutes left. We sit here, we talk, but 4 minutes is plenty of time.
Yeah.
Back out, inside. I mean, that's good basketball is what it is.
It just doesn't get, why make it harder for yourself? Why not make it easy just like that?
He did just that. Fort going quick, exactly what you
Fort
have to do.
Just can't get a bucket, but fortunately they still have possession.
If you were the Fort coach, What would be your biggest takeaway from your team's performance today?
Biggest takeaway? Clearly the free throws are working, so we got to get fouls. We got to manufacture them, so we got to take it to the hole more. And we got to take less three-point shots. They're just not falling.
Here we go. 34.
Moving it around, making the ball the quickest player on the court.
Back to the corner, inside. Oh, heartbreaking.
It's just like, just the lid on that rim, man.
Heartbreaking for four. Under 4 minutes left. Under 4 minutes left. I mean, if you're a Hudson's Bay player, you almost have to enjoy this feeling right now.
Absolutely. Who doesn't enjoy a win when it's your team? Oh, my. Second chance. That's killing them.
From the corner.
No good, but, you know, he does not mind. The lead is solid right now. And this
62 to 46.
He hoped it.
I would say, as Ford drives and gets the foul, I would say probably about the scoring you would expect. Both teams played pretty good defense and pretty good offense.
For sure. You know, I think Ford really had us going with those free throws. So, but, you know, Bay just pulled away in the end. I guess they had more in the tank. You know, you really got to hit both these free throws.
If there's one thing we know Ford can do,
it's hit free throws.
Hit free throws.
Getting fouls, who knows? But hitting them, they can do that.
Late in the game. 15 points, 14 points difference between both teams.
Yeah, not looking good. There's about 3 minutes left, so that's about 7 points a quarter that you got to get, and you got to hold the other team to zero.
Travel there.
Travel. Bad turnover, but what is a good turnover?
Not a travel.
No. Bay is not taking their foot off the gas. They are still man pressing.
Bay's done a great job so far hanging on to their lead. See if that continues this week.
Seems like they're really hunting for that five.
They're down to the final, but they get it. Final stretch. 62-48.
Wow.
Hey, wow. Great move. Really great move.
It was basically a one on five there. Just took the whole team on.
.236 left in the fourth quarter. We got a stoppage.
You know, they say the longest point in a basketball game is the last 2 minutes. Say it takes the longest.
I mean, I haven't seen it yet, but I'm going to go ahead and agree.
Yeah, we're about to hit that threshold, so we'll see it. And then you can see if it's true.
Noah. You're a student at Hudson's Bay.
I am a student at Hudson's Bay.
How do you feel about this win?
I feel like it's a big win. Winning one game is tough to take, but winning two, you know, easier to go home with that.
Personally, I'm just impressed by the effort that we displayed.
Really, they're diving on the floor. They really won that one.
I think you have to be proud to play for this team after this game.
You could say that.
Bay's taking it up. 2:28 left. 16-point game still. We had a great game in the first quarter, and so far in the second half, Bay has really pulled away.
Yeah. I mean, I won't. But you could call it. You could say it's over. Locks it up and bounds it.
From the corner into the paint, no good. A lot of floaters today.
A lot of floaters. If you're a coach, typically coaches don't like that from high school players. It's for high school players, it's usually an inefficient shot. So, but I mean, Bay's winning.
You could certainly say that.
You could say it.
In fact, it's true.
It is a true statement.
Inbound here for Bay.
He's gonna pull, isn't he? No.
We got a different lineup in here.
That's usually admitting you won when you put your
results. We are down to the final 2 minutes, the longest 2 minutes.
Hey, that's what people say. Usually it's because of fouls. Such as that.
Foul on the floor, I believe. Is this a big win for the Hudson's Bay
Massive
coach?
Massive win.
For the
especially
coach?
When you have not a lot. Oh. Oh. You know, he was just like, I'm in here. I'm gonna shoot it. Didn't matter what kind of shot it was.
I'm sure that all went through his mind. Is this a big win for the coach?
For the coach?
Yeah.
I think it's a big win for anyone in the Hudson's Bay. If, you know, we were at zero wins for just so long, so the fact that we got one not too long ago, and now we're getting a second one. Fingers crossed. I mean, we are up 20, but I guess you never know.
More free throws from Fort here. I gotta say, so far, the last 2 minutes.
Quite long.
A long 25 seconds.
Yeah.
So far. Number zero. At the line. He misses the first.
Liam Kislovich. Apologies.
Liam.
Just Liam. Just Liam works. Come on, Liam. Gotta hit these.
Shooters roll.
Shooters, I guess.
66-49. We're nearing the end of the game.
You know, it's moments like these in the game where it's really
wow. That's a great floater.
I mean, just a circus shot, but clearly he had the confidence to take it.
Fort tries a three, trying to get back in the game. It's no good.
You know, it's usually this moment in the game.
In and out.
He just wants a three.
In and out for Isaac. Would have given him 70. 70 on the night.
70.
That's a good number.
It is a good number. Better than the one before.
49-68. Two free throws here for the Trappers.
Swish. At this point, you just play to prove something, so you're not really playing for a win.
And I think a lot of these guys are reserves, maybe fighting for minutes.
Absolutely. A lot of these are young guys trying to work their way up, trying to, you know, prove themselves, and this is their shot to do it.
Miss on the free throw. Pretty good board.
Why not?
Corner three. I'll tell you why not. They nothing, missed.
Nothing to lose.
Fort's, Bay's going to take it up.
The Bay is loud. They are happy.
Oh, man, the fans are. Oh!
Look at them.
Fans are having a great time. What a shot.
That was a shot.
Oh, they called the travel.
No.
You know what? It doesn't matter.
Let him have it.
That was a great shot. Was that a rainbow?
Yeah, it's just a high. I put a high arc on it. Don't ask me why.
I didn't expect you to know. Bay's going to take it up, man. 38 seconds left. 68-50.
Yeah.
What do you think? They shoot here?
I think, there's a shot clock, so yeah. You gotta wait through it, and then now they're gonna shoot.
Oh, they called a foul.
They called a foul? The game's over, dude.
Well, we could get to 20 here.
Okay. Don't these refs have places to be?
Is part of you playing to beat your rival by more at this point in the game?
I think if that was true, they would.
69-50. 19-point lead for Fort Vancouver. I mean, for Hudson's Bay. Apologies.
19.
Another rainbow free throw. This is pickup basketball at this point.
Yeah. You might as well stat chase.
69-50 still.
We're pressing. We're proving something.
Bay is pressing. I don't know. Seems redundant, up 19, but...
Hey, these are reserves, looking for a spot, I guess, but... Yeah, he's going to dribble it out, like a good score.
The Hudson's Bay Eagles are going to take this game and take it by a sizable margin, too.
Yeah, no ifs, ands, or buts. That was definitely a
great win for Hudson's Bay, 69-50. Hudson's Bay Eagles over the Fort Vancouver Trappers.
And they're going to celebrate.
We got the cheer squad out.
They love it. A home win.
Fans are excited. Fans are excited.
Absolutely.
Of course. This is a second win in not too long of a period for Hudson's Bay. Do you think turning around a little bit?
I mean, you like to hope so. Usually games have momentum, but seasons also have momentum for sure. So Bay's on a good momentum, good swing right now. Gonna keep it going.
A lot of great performances tonight, and ultimately just a great performance by the team.
Absolutely. Just the second chance, just those hustle points, you know? And some points that don't necessarily show up on the stat sheet, like hustling for a loose ball or, you know, really fighting for the tough rebound that ultimately won them the game.
Well, certainly proved who the better team was tonight. Second half, big run. Bay outscored them by 16.
Yep. I mean, that first half really had us going. It was really anyone's game, but Bay just pulled away. It looked like they weren't scared at all, had no concern. Maybe they were playing possum.
From everybody here at the Eagles Sports Network, we want to thank you so much for tuning in. We had a blast broadcasting it. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. And we'll see you next time. Thank you very much.